This is The Rumor Report with Angela Yee. Rumor has it. Rumor. On The Breakfast Club.
So listen up.
Well, you all know that Jay-Z recently did that deal where he sold half of the stake in Ace of Spades to LVMH Louis Vuitton Moët Hennessy. So Forbes is valuing the deal at about $630 million, which means that Jay-Z would get about $315 million in that deal.
Sounds like good business to me.
That's amazing.
And you still own 50% of Ace of Spades.
Yep.
Now, and now you have a bigger distributor, the biggest champagne distributor in the world. Mm-hmm. Come on, man.
All right, so Forbes also in this article talked about other celebrity deals that have been done in the past 5 years, like George Clooney. Diageo purchased his tequila company, Casamigos, back in 2017. That transaction valued the company at up to $1 billion, mm-hmm. including $700 million up front and another $300 million based on performance over the following 10 years. So what did George Clooney end up getting? $200 million pre-tax. That's why he was a top paid actor of 2018 because of that deal. Kylie Jenner, with her Kylie Cosmetics, she ended up giving away a 51% stake of the brand back in January of 2020. She ended up getting $540 million pre-tax, and she still has 44.1% stake in the company. Other deals, Rihanna. Of course, you know, Rihanna did a deal with LVMH, and she did that makeup brand with them, and they said she owns 50%. Well, she said that LVMH owns 50%. She owns 15%. That 15% is about $450 million of the $3 billion brand.
I love it. And I just want to say F you to all you people, mm-hmm. that I've seen you guys talking online, talking about, oh, she doesn't own, she only owns 15%.
Oh, my God.
15% is $500 million.
15% of a $4 billion company, you digital D-heads.
My goodness.
Could you just
And that's
die?
Just the makeup, by the way. She also has her fashion house, Fenty, which is also a joint venture with LVMH. And she also, of course, has her lingerie line. Her,
I would take a percent of
that. The crazy part is everybody runs around celebrating owning 100% of nothing.
When all of these
people who actually have big businesses that are making billions, $100 million, none of them own 100% either.
100% of
this
nothing!
This person has a percentage, this person has a percentage. They're all working together to make something huger. So when they have these big sales, they end up with numbers like this.
Give me a 1% of a $4 billion company.
Come on, man.
Now, Kanye has a more complicated deal with Adidas with Yeezy, and they said that he gets a royalty of approximately 11% of Yeezy revenue, and based on revenues of $1.3 billion in 2019, they said he likely got about $140 million in royalties.
He only has how much? 11%?
First of all, don't say only.
No, so it's a, no. It's a,
no, he
said
have
it's
more
a
than
different,
that.
No, it's a, I was trying to say it's a more complicated deal. It's a profit sharing agreement. So
okay.
He owns
that sounds right.
His brand, Yeezy,
yeah.
But Adidas handles the production, marketing, and distribution. So he gets a royalty from that.
Okay. All right. Now that makes sense. Because he created, he started, he founded, he built, he put that together, and he went against all those companies because he wanted to keep ownership. That's how I was bugging when you said 11%, but it's more to that.
He still has ownership, though.
Yeah.
He has ownership percentage.
All right, now Big Sean says that he contemplated suicide many times and even had a gun in his hand. He was doing an interview for Facebook Watch, and here's what he said.
Sometimes it takes more than a song. Sometimes it takes more than an album. Sometimes it takes you really spending time with yourself, and that's one of the things I was neglecting. That was my mentality, was taking care of everybody else and trying not to look soft. So I'm working, exhausting myself for years and years and years, and I couldn't get through the day, you know, without feeling terrible. I was sure contemplating suicide a lot of times, you know, having guns in my hands, and just really just, you know, feeling it for real.
Totally get it.
All right, love and light, of course, to Big Sean.
Yeah, I love it. I mean, all these black men having conversations about their mental health, all these black men having conversations about self-care, all these black men, you know, being vulnerable, talking about doing the work on themselves to deal with their traumas. I love it. Dropping the clues bombs for Big Sean. Invest in your mental wealth. Okay?
All right, and T.I. is not returning for Ant-Man 3, Marvel Studios' upcoming Ant-Man and the Wasp, Quantumania. Now, they are saying they're not sure why. It's unclear if it's related to the recent accusations against him, but he will not be returning for Ant-Man 3.
Yeah, he was never supposed to be in Ant-Man 3, though. Because if you know anything about the Marvel Universe, they are going to the space. They're going to space. They're going to the cosmos now. Okay, they're playing in the quantum realm, in the multiverses. I don't think T.I. fits into that equation.
All right, well, that is your rumor report.
All right, thank you, Miss G. Charlamagne, who you giving that donka to?
For after the hour, let's talk about America being a businessman. I need Greg Abbott, okay, governor of Texas, and Governor Tate Reeves in Mississippi to come to the front of the congregation. We'd like to have a word with them, please.
All right, we'll get to that next. It's The Breakfast Club. Good morning.